I call your attention to the book of Isaiah, the 9th chapter. Isaiah, the 9th chapter. We're going to read verse 2. Isaiah, the 9th chapter, verse 2. The 9th chapter, verse 2. And I'll be reading from the New King James Version. And we will find these words. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. And those who dwelt in the land of the shadow of death, upon them a light has shined. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. And those who dwelt in the land of the shadow of death, upon them a light has shined. I want to talk about moral and spiritual darkness. Moral and spiritual darkness is the subject we're going to talk about this morning. Moral and spiritual darkness. A great philosopher by the name of Victor Hugo once said, if a soul is left in darkness, sins will be committed. But the guilty one is not he who commits the sin, but he who causes the darkness. We are living in times of moral and spiritual darkness.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Caused by our deliberate decisions to leave God out of the scheme of things. Yes,
right.
The darkness is so deep and widespread that people cannot tell morality from immorality, sweetness from bitterness, and sacredness from sacrilegiousness. When people are raised and nurtured in moral and spiritual darkness, it affects their senses. It affects their sensations. It affects their emotions, their lifestyle, their talk, their character, and their personality. You see, it is easy for them to put drugs before dignity, politics before principle, rights before righteousness, attitude before aptitude, criminality before common sense, violence before virtue, and churchianity before Christianity. You see, all people can do is reason and represent and respond out of the darkness in which they are living. We are becoming an increasingly ungodly nation. That's no wonder the laws of our land are increasingly reflecting the darkness that's in our hearts, minds, and souls. Moral and spiritual darkness have spread its tentacles in every institution of our nation. We see the darkness in our families. We see darkness in our schools. We see it in the communities. We see it in our society. We see it in the government. And yes, even in the church. You see, moral and spiritual darkness have arrested our nation. Wrecked our economy, taken our future, separated us from God and one another. We are a nation sitting and walking in moral and spiritual darkness. It is dark in many American families. Husbands and wives are divorcing one another. Children are killing their parents. Too many fathers are not involved in the life of their children. Too many mothers are left alone to fend for themselves. And too many children are having children. There is moral and spiritual darkness in many families, which are the foundation of our nation.
Yes.
Not only is there moral and spiritual darkness in families, there's also moral and spiritual darkness in our society.
Yes.
Our society is so sick that we have lost the capacity to preserve the sacredness of life.
Yes.
We are killing babies in record numbers.
Yes.
Across this nation, black men are being shot down by police for simple traffic violations. People are ending up dead for cutting someone off while driving. Young women are ending up dead while jogging. People are setting fires and killing property and human lives. In some cases, the firemen are setting these fires. At the fire station. Racism and terrorism are nagging reality in our society. Gun violence is so out of control that we don't know what to do about it. Everybody got a weapon. Nobody wants to lay the weapon down and resolve conflict like rational human beings ought to do. All the things we want to do is resolve conflict by violence, by shooting each other, and it is senseless. The deaths in this nation, especially in Chicago. We are a society sitting and walking in moral and spiritual darkness. Not only is there moral and spiritual darkness in society, there's moral and spiritual darkness in the government. What kind of government will allow 2,000 to 3,000 people to die by gun violence each year in a city like Chicago and they not do anything about it? What kind of government will allow people in Flint, Michigan to suffer from a lack of clean drinking water when they got the power to do something about it? What kind of government will spend more money on being incarcerated than educate people? What kind of government would allow people to get the best, or them to get the best health care, and they deny that health care to the average American?
Hallelujah.
Are y'all praying again?
Yeah.
While the rich are playing economic games, the poor are dying of a lack of resources, services, and opportunity. Our government is sitting and walking in moral and spiritual darkness. Now, out of all the places where you would find moral and spiritual darkness, you wouldn't expect to find moral and spiritual darkness in the postmodern church. But even in the church, there is moral and spiritual darkness.
Yes, sir.
Anytime a church establishes its own righteousness, or will not submit to the righteousness of God, it is sitting in spiritual and moral darkness. Anytime a church will stand up against injustice, will speak out against the devastating effects of racism and sexism, is in moral and spiritual darkness. Anytime a church accommodates the culture while compromising Jesus Christ, is sitting in moral and spiritual darkness. Even in the church, people are walking in darkness. Now, I heard that there's a church in Georgia where the male pastor married another man. And that man is sitting in the pulpit as the first somebody. I'm not going to say he's the first lady because he's not a lady. I said the pastor didn't marry another man.
I ain't surprised.
This is just how distorted and perverted the church has become. Now, I don't care what anybody says, this is not morally and spiritually right before God. Now, if the postmodern church is not going to operate by the word of God and be guided by the Holy Spirit, then don't call yourself the church of God.
Yeah.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
It is said. But there is moral and spiritual darkness even in the postmodern church.
Yes, sir.
Darkness is all around us. It has enveloped us as a nation. We are like the people in the scripture. We are sitting and walking in moral and spiritual darkness.
Yes, sir.
We are sitting in darkness if we believe that moral change would just roll in on the wheels of inevitability.
All right, all right.
We are sitting in darkness if we believe pushing God out of our public institution will make us a fair and balanced nation.
All right.
We are sitting in darkness if we believe that we can have peace in the absence of justice.
Yes, sir.
We are sitting in darkness if we think that we can turn or run a nation on borrowed money. We are sitting in darkness if we think taking necessities from the many and giving luxuries to the few. We are sitting in darkness if we believe that the church can change the world while the church is sleeping with the world. We are sitting in darkness when we refuse to let justice roll down like water and righteousness like a mighty stream. Moral and spiritual darkness has covered our nation. But the good news is, we don't have to remain in darkness. Only when it gets dark enough can we see the stars. We can come out of our moral and spiritual darkness. Light has come. And as the Apostle John said, the light shines in the darkness. And the darkness comprehended it not. Martin Luther King Jr. said, darkness cannot drive out darkness. Only light can drive out darkness. And Jesus is the light of the world. For God did not send his son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. Light has come. We no longer have to stumble in the darkness. We no longer have to live in the darkness and operate from dark places. Light has come. And I'm not talking about incandescent lights. I'm not talking about fluorescent light. I'm not talking about LED light. I'm not talking about flash light. I'm not talking about laser light. The light of the world. Christ by heavens adored. Jesus, the light of the world. Christ, the everlasting Lord. Jesus is the light of the world. Hail the heaven-born Prince of Peace. Jesus, the light of the world. Hail the Son of righteousness. Jesus, the light of the world. Walk in the light. Beautiful light. Oh, yes. That we might walk in the light, that we might have some grace.
replacement.
Yes.
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 Touch it.
Yes.
Bring light to it, Lord.
Yes. Talk with it.
Heal it, Lord.
Please, Lord.
Yes.
Bring comfort there, Lord.
Yes.
Grow it into the righteousness.
Oh, yeah.
Yes. Talk with it. Talk with it.
Father God, even those places that we don't want to be seen, let it be seen by you.
Yes. Talk with it.
And dealt with by you.
Yes.
Let us be obedient.
Yes.
Lord. Correction.
Yes, talk with it, talk with it.
Father God, is in the body of Christ, as we shine full light,
yes,
we can bring great light to
the dark. Yes.
As we shine our full light, we can change the government.
Oh, I guess we can.
We can change our family.
Yes.
We can change the church.
Yes.
And Father God, we can change the culture.
Lord, yes.
Please, Father God, let us walk in great light and great joy.
Yes.
Thank you for each person that is at the altar, Lord. We pray that you would touch their hearts, their bodies, their minds, their souls, their anything, Lord, that is in their need today.
Yeah, talk with
you. Thank you, Father God. You will provide for them in ways they may not even understand. You may not be able to comprehend, but we thank you for the provision.
Yes.
We thank you, Father God, for those who are in the pews that have needs as well. We thank you, Father God.
Yes.
Thank you that Sister Johnson is here.
Yes.
Thank you, Father God, that you are touching and healing those who are lost someone.
Yes.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you.
Yes. You're an awesome God.
Yes, Lord.
Yes. We thank you for our pastor. We pray that you continue to heal his
body. Yes.
We thank you that you're going to have it so his back is giving him no more trouble.
What?
And he'll be able to
talk with him. Talk with him.
And put glory in your name.
Yes.
Yes.